difficult. I'm at the Chennai beach in Besanagar. It's called the Elliot's Beach. And behind me, you can see the waves crashing in. And the learning from the waves is very, very important to understand how worry arises in the mind. A worry is like a wave. It arises and it tries to invite you to hold it. It tells you that you must now pick me up. But if you look at the nature of the waves, you can understand the nature of worry. A worry is never permanent. It will arise like a wave. It will come and it will invite you, it will provoke you. But if you don't pick it up, it will recede. Similarly, a worry will arise. But if you don't pick it up, it will recede. So you have an option not to worry. And that's why I always talk about non-worrying as being a very important part of happiness. I tell people that as long as you choose not to pick up a worry, it will not trouble you. See, there are two kinds of problems. One that you can solve and another that you can't solve. A problem that you can't solve, you don't need to worry about. And a problem that you can solve, you don't need to worry about. So worry is futile. Worrying is futile. Treat it like a wave. Let it arise. If you don't like it, step back. Don't pick it up. Don't allow it to touch you. And if you leave it, it will recede. If you understand this concept of the wave and worrying, you will understand that life can be lived happily despite your circumstances.